So now we have understood the UDP client and server. Now we move to TCP. Okay, so go to the TCP package and of course close everything if you have any running program, close it. And now we are going to open TCP server. So just to summarize, with UDP, we have datagram socket, whatever in the client and the server, and datagram packet, whatever in the client and the server. Now, we will have a special syntax for the server and a special syntax for the client. So first of all, in order to create a TCP socket, we have to use the server socket class, okay, initially equal to null. I'm going to open a TCP socket server on the port 1234. It's a port of my choice. Okay, in the previous example, I always make throw exceptions. That's why the code was kind of easy and readable. Okay, just to see here, you have code without any try and catch because I have throw all the exceptions here. Now, in the second example, I'm going to make try and catch for every exception. So maybe the code will look a little bit more dense, but you know, it's just a matter of a better way of dealing with the different exceptions that may come. So here, we are going to try to open a server socket, okay? And this is like file. When you would like to open a file for reading or writing, you are going to make try, because the file might not be available. Same thing here in TCP. The port might not be available. You'd like to open on a port that is already open. And just to let you understand this now, let me come back to the UDP server. I'm going to open the UDP server. So now it's open, right? Now I would like to open the same UDP server again. And it says there is a bind exception. The address already in use. It's actually the port already in use. Okay, so we cannot open two servers on the same ports because this is going to make a confusion. Two applications running at the same port, okay, it's like two persons having the same office and they are in different office, so it doesn't make any sense. So every application should have its own port, okay, otherwise you will have a runtime error. That's why here also we make a try catch, so that to make sure that we have only one server running. Okay, so you can see here, if it is created, TCP server created on port, or otherwise we are going to catch an error, the server with port cannot be open. Then, like any server, we are going to make an endless loop while true. And here we are going to create a client socket. And see the difference with UDP. With UDP, you have always a datagram socket. And here we have a socket for client socket and server socket for TCP socket server. Okay, so whenever you would like to read, you are going to open a client socket using the socket class, okay? And then you are going to wait for incoming request. Okay, look, the syntax is a bit different. Client socket equal server socket dot accept. It's not like UDP. UDP, it's starting with receiving. That's why we make dot receive. The server socket dot receive with UDP. صح ولا؟ Here we are not going to start with receiving. We are start first with the handshake process, the three-way handshake process. So I must accept the connection first. Okay? That's why we have accept. So the client socket, I'm going accept, we return the client socket that made the three-way handshake. And is going to pass to the receiving if the handshake is accepted. Okay? So this is a blocking function that is going to listen to the incoming client request. If this is fine, okay, otherwise we are going to throw an error, cannot accept client request and exit. The third is process client request. So we are going to process this client socket now, it has a message, I'm going to process that message, depends on my application, right? Okay, we can do all the things here, but for sake of, I created a method that is called process client request, but we can put it on the same, on the same block, no problem. But this is clearer. Okay, so here we are going processing the incoming request. We try. So remember that we said for TCP we need to have an input stream and an output stream. So input is for what? For reading the incoming message. And output is for sending the message. There are different ways, okay, but I'm going to show you the most common way. So usually what we do, we make, so this is the output stream. We can do something like output stream, output equal to this, okay, and input stream, because there are different levels here, equal client dot. So here we are going to receive bytes, okay, but we would like to have more affordable ways how to read and write. We can actually make get bytes and read send bytes, but a more appropriate thing is here to make something like a stream reader and a print stream. So two wrapper classes, okay? These are two wrapper classes for the input stream and for the output stream that allows to actually process better these streams. Okay? So print stream is going to take the output stream, so we can use the method println or print in order to send the stream to the client. Okay? And here, this is input stream reader. We can actually use a buffer reader to read the input. So another level for the read, we are going to use a buffer reader. Okay, so all of this, why? Because we would like to use the read line. We would like to use the read line method that is available in the buffer reader class. Okay, streaming, this is a complete area of Java. There are different ways, from generic classes, the generic classes, new streams, but several specialization. Okay, so here you have a buffer reader, it has a read line, it's going to read all the line in the buffer. Otherwise, you have to read it yourself. When you enter the buffer, you read it byte by byte, then you make concatenation. This is a bit longer. But we can use read line that is in the buffer reader. So buffer reader, it takes an input stream as parameter, and input stream, it takes an input of the socket as parameter. Okay, have them lines, they repeat all the time. You don't have to change them. Okay, so our objective, now I receive the message, I would like to read it, sahwala. So there are different ways. This is one of the ways, which is actually one of the easiest way. Okay, my ultimate objective is to use the read line, because I'm going to read the message as a line from the buffer. So in order to do this, I need to have a buffered reader object. So this is the buffered reader object. I start from the bottom to the top. So the buffered reader object, it takes as parameter an input stream. Okay, so I provide the input stream that I have created from the socket input stream. So socket input stream has an input stream parameter. Okay, I put it into an input stream reader and then into a buffer reader. Okay, so finally I'm able to extract my string message, my stream header. Okay, otherwise you can do something like input dot, you can read here. Okay, you read the bytes, you put it into an array of bytes, and then you extract it if you want. Okay, but usually when you have a string message, this is a very common way in programming to do it. Okay, it's not a problem if you don't understand the detail, because you have to understand all the streaming process, how it works in Java, which is beyond this networking introduction. But for you to know, this is like the common way how to get the incoming message from the socket.
We can reuse this for any program.
Any program. This actually doesn't change. This doesn't change. What changes is something, how to process the message. Okay?
Okay? Which
is the method. Yeah. So how to process the message. Now I receive my message. Okay? And then I'm going to send hello world from TCP server. This is my response back. Okay, the response. So here, because I have a print stream, I'm going to use println to send the message back. Okay, is it clear?
This is part of the handshake?
Yes, part of the handshake. No, no, this is the data transfer now. Look, I received the message. I read the message. Now I send the response back. Okay, so here we can say send the response back.
But not yet processed.
This is processed. Okay, now we don't, this is like an echo server. You send the message, I respond with the message.
Okay.
There is no particular processing. You are going to do this into an exercise just later. Okay. And then I will println the message. This will send back to the client. مثل ما سوينا write مع ال UDP. Okay, with the UDP. Now we use println in order to send back to the client. Okay, so let me summarize. We create a server socket on a certain port here. Okay, then we create our client socket, and then the client socket will be equal to the output of accept, the result of the accept, which is going to listen to any incoming request. Okay, and finally, if there is a request, so this is blocking. When there is a request, it's going to process the client request. Process client request, it creates an input stream, an output stream. Using a buffer reader, it reads the message, and then using the print stream, it's going to send back the message. Okay, all these are the details on how to do this. Let's look at our client demonstration now, TCP client. Okay, it's intuitive. I'm going to create a client socket. Okay, my server is the local host or any IP address. So what does this do? This method, okay, I'm going to write a message here. Okay, this attempting to connect to the TCP server. So this is an attempt. I'm not sure, maybe the server is not ready. Okay, look now, with UDP, okay, I'm going to come back to UDP later if we are going to start UDP before the client before the server. We will see the difference. Okay, now I'm going to attempt to connect to this. Maybe it's not active.
And because the try catch is the handshake?
Yes. No, the handshake is here.
Yeah.
It's already done here, the three-way handshake. If it is connected, it's going to go forward. Otherwise, it's going to raise an exception. Okay? So, same thing. Even for the server, I need to have a print stream. Okay, and input stream, now I think you know what is this. Okay, and then, okay, I just make a press key because we are going to press the key before sending the message, otherwise I can remove this, it will not change anything. Okay, it's just stopping the client until I press the key. And then I'm going to formulate my message, okay, and then you have to make print stream dot print message. Okay, and finally, I will wait for the response from the server. Okay, okay, this is getting the response from the server. Very simple. Okay, so we use the same buffer reader as an input stream now. I use the print stream to send, and now I will use the input stream to read from the server when it sends back a response. Then the server, and if you remember, I used at the end in the process, I used the print in order to send the response back. So I need to have an input stream here to read the response back. And finally, I'm going to show what message received from the server. So let's have a look. We now execute our server. first, and then we execute our client. It's going to tell press a key. I'm going to press any key, then enter. Okay, so it will tell you hello world from TCP server. This is the response from the server. Look, the server sends back hello world from TCP server. This is the response. And now if we look at the server, what it did receive, okay, processing incoming request. Okay, look now, waiting for incoming request after creating the server, processing incoming request, the message received from the client, hello world from TCP client. And then what the server does again, it's going to wait for another message. Run again the client demo. Okay, press a key. And you are going to see a second time, it was sent a second time. Okay? And our server, okay, now close the TCP server. And start the TCP client. What do you see? Why?
Because the port is not.
Because the server is down. The server is down. It's not working. Okay, let's go back to our UDP now. The UDP server is not working. I'm going now to use the UDP client. Is there any error?
No.
No. This is because TCP, it's connection oriented. I want to make the handshake, but I couldn't find the server, so it fails. The UDP doesn't care. The server is not there, I'm going to send. Yes, it doesn't care. So that's why now you can start a UDP client without any problem, but you cannot start a TCP client unless you have your TCP server working. Yes. So now, okay, now it's pretty much fine. If you are going to change the port number of the client, I'm going to put 5, okay? And if I run the client again, it's not there, although the server is running because I changed the port number. Yeah, because the port identifies which application is running, okay? So I need to put the port exactly the same as the TCP, okay? So that it can, look now, there is no problem, and finally, everything works fine back.
So, can you listen to multiple ports?
No, a server listens on one port, but you create so many servers. If you want several ports, you create more than one server, yes.
For the UDP, if I send a message, there is no, the server is down. Does the message hang there or is it lost?
It's lost.
It
will be lost in the last router when it doesn't find the... It will be sent to the machine.
Okay.
It will be sent to the computer. Yeah, but since the application is not there, it's going to be just thrown by the operating system. Okay. Because no application is found. Okay. So I think now you understood at this level how to make a UDP server, a UDP client, a TCP server, and a TCP client, and the difference between both. Of course, I'm sure that you don't master too much the syntax, and this is very normal because this is your first interaction with this, but when you come back at home and you your own way, you are going to be more professional on that. It's very simple. Okay, now you are going to do it yourself. You have exercise number 2, okay, about the TCP client. And I'm not going to open because I will not show you the solution. So you have different tasks. Okay, you are going to create a client-server application where the client will send 2 numbers and the server will respond by sending back the sum of these 2 numbers. Okay, so you are going to apply what you have learned in order to build this server. I'm going to give you 10 minutes because we have to complete the other parts of this training.